Good morning. In this video session, we are going to learn refining process of crude oil to get the petroleum products under the unit of fuel. The learning outcome of this session is that students will be able to describe the refining process of crude oil to get the different petroleum products. The content we are going to learn in this session is origin of petroleum, mining of petroleum, refining of crude oil, and different fractions of petroleum. Now, what is petroleum? Petroleum or crude oil is a dark greenish brown viscous oil found deep in earth crust. So what is petroleum? It is a dark greenish brown viscous oil found deep in earth crust. Generally, the petroleum, which is known as the crude oil, it is composed mainly of various hydrocarbons like straight chain, paraffins, cycloparaffins or naphthalenes, olefins and aromatics together with small amounts of organic compounds like oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur. The oil is usually found floating upon a layer of brine and has a layer of gas on it. So, what is origin of petroleum? According to the modern theory, petroleum has resulted from the partial decomposition of animals and vegetables, that is organic bodies. Because of changes in earth, the organic bodies gets buried inside the earth crust, where the bodies remain for several years in presence of moisture, chemical elements, pressure. And under such situation, all these organic bodies slowly gets converted into various hydrocarbons by the bacterial decomposition under anaerobic and strongly reducing conditions. So this is the origin of petroleum. Now, how the petroleum oil, crude oil, is bring on the surface of the earth, and that process is known as mining of petroleum. To bring the crude oil from the earth crust on the surface is known as mining of petroleum. It is done by drilling holes in the earth crust and sinking pipes up to the oil bearing porous rock. Oil usually comes out due to hydrostatic pressure of natural gas, but sometimes the pressure of the gas is very low, and in such case the oil naturally will not come on the surface. In such cases, it may be mechanically pumped by using lift pumps. Particularly, the lift pump consists of two coaxial pipes lowered into the oil bed, and the compressed air is forced through the outer pipe. As the reaction, the oil comes out from the inner pipe. The oil is conveyed to refinery by a system of pipeline. So this whole process is called as mining of petroleum. So origin indicates how it forms below the earth crust, and mining indicates how we are bringing the crude oil on the surface of the earth. So this is explained with the help of diagram also. We can see the boat diagram. The oil is formed below the earth crust because of pressure, because of chemical elements, because of bacterial action, and organic bodies are slowly converting into the crude oil. Because of the pressure of natural gases, normally the oil will come out. Otherwise, as per the second diagram, we have to introduce the mechanical lifting pumps and we have to bring the oil on the surface. That is explained with the help of diagram. Now, once we bring the oil on the surface, we know that it is composed of different petroleum products, and therefore it is needed to separate into the pure components. So the separation of pure components from a crude oil is known as refining of crude oil. The crude oil is separated into various useful fractions by fractional distillation and finally converted into the desired specific products. This process is known as refining of crude oil, and the plants set up for this purpose are called as oil refineries. The process is carried out in different steps. The step one is that separation of water. We know that we are taking the crude oil from the earth crust. Therefore, the crude oil consists of a considerable amount of the water, and therefore it is needed to separate first. The crude oil from the oil well is an extremely stable emulsion of oil and salty water. The process of freezing water from the oil is carried out by passing the crude oil in between two highly charged electrodes. The colloidal water droplets get separated when the crude oil is passed in between two electrodes. This is step one. Step two is that removal of sulfur and sulfur compounds. Somewhere the geological condition is that the earth is rich in sulfur salts. Therefore, the considerable amount of sulfur compound may come in a crude oil. And if we use without removing sulfur and sulfur compound, it may cause the several environmental issues. Because while we burn such a fuel, the sulfur present in a fuel may come in atmosphere in the form of sulfur dioxide. Therefore, it is must to remove sulfur before the use of petroleum products. How it is removed? It is removed by treating the crude oil with copper oxide. A reaction occurs with sulfur compounds, which results in the formation of copper sulfide, which is then removed by filtration. Now here I would like to ask you one question. Sulfur is removed from crude oil by treating it with option A, copper oxide, option B, copper sulfide, option C, copper nitrate, option D, all of these. How the sulfur is removed from crude oil? Think about that. The correct answer is option A, copper oxide. Because copper oxide, when it is treated with the crude oil containing sulfur, sulfur gets converted into copper sulfide precipitate that can be separated by filtration. Now this is the diagram of refining. After removal of water and sulfur, the oil is free heated in a furnace at around 400 degrees centigrade. And the vapors are allowed to enter in a tall cylindrical tower, which is called as oil refining column. The column consists of different stainless steel plates through which the vapor passes from bottom to top and it gets condensed. Therefore, the first fraction coming out of the fractional column is having a high boiling point, and as the boiling point decreases, the lower boiling point fractions will come later. This is shown with the help of diagram. This is the fractional distillation, how it is carried out. Just now we have explained the diagram. The crude oil is then heated to 400 degrees centigrade, where all the volatile constituent extract residue are evaporated. The hot vapors are then passed through a fractionating column, and the different fractions are getting separated on the basis of their boiling point. Each tray is provided with the small opening covered with a loose cap. As the vapors go up, they become gradually cooled and fractional condensation takes place at different heights of the column. Higher boiling fraction condenses first, while the lower boiling fractions turn by turn. So all that material I have prepared by using a textbook of engineering chemistry. by Jain and Jain. And even I added the reference for the figure of mining of crude oil as well as refining of crude oil. Thank you.